The rise of humanoid robots, especially advanced AI gynoids, could transform the workplace more radically than any previous technology. It's easy to picture reception desks run by flawless androids, retail stores staffed by tireless assistants, even schools and hospitals relying on humanoid robots instead of people. For businesses, the benefits are obvious: lower costs, 24/7 productivity, and staff who never get sick or demand holidays. But for humanity, the story is more complicated. Millions of jobs could vanish almost overnight, not just manual labor, but roles we once thought safe because they required empathy, trust, or communication. Now here's the paradox. In theory, a world of gynoids could free people from the grind of everyday work. More time to relax, create, and enjoy life. But without jobs, most people lose their income, and without income, all that free time becomes meaningless. You might have endless weekends, but no money to spend on them. This is where governments face their biggest challenge. Our entire system is built on people working, paying taxes, and funding everything from healthcare to pensions. Even today, many governments complain about the strain of an aging population. People are living longer thanks to medical advances, yet pension funds were never designed to support decades of retirement. So what happens when vast numbers of citizens no longer work at all? Who pays for the services, the infrastructure, the social safety nets? The money has to come from somewhere. Some futurists suggest new models: universal basic income funded by taxes on corporations that deploy robots, or even direct levies on the productivity of AI. But those ideas are still experimental and politically explosive. The bigger question is one of fairness. If gynoids generate the wealth but humans are cut out of the workforce, will society split into two classes: those who own the robots and those who live off whatever scraps the system provides? Technology always promises progress, but it also disrupts the balance of power. The arrival of gynoids in the workplace could either create a new golden age of leisure and creativity, or it could deepen inequality and social unrest. The choice will come down not just to engineers, but to policymakers, communities, and all of us. So, when gynoids take the jobs, who takes responsibility for keeping humanity afloat? Will we finally embrace a new economic system, or cling to the old one until it breaks? Let me know what you think. Would you welcome a life of leisure,